In today's video, we'll take a look at how to loudness normalize your video for uploading to online platforms such as YouTube using Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here and find this video helpful, I upload new videos every week, so consider subscribing. It really helps out the channel. A little while back, Curtis Judd released a couple of videos that talk about volume versus loudness and how to properly loudness normalize your videos before uploading to YouTube. I'm neither a sound engineer, nor do I even come close to having the knowledge or experience that Curtis does, so I'm not even going to try to explain the theory behind this. For that, I strongly recommend you watch Curtis's videos, which I'll link in the video description. What I'm going to do today is expand on what Curtis's videos demonstrate and show you how to apply that to your videos in Final Cut Pro. Let's just briefly touch on loudness versus volume. They're two different things. The best way I can think of to demonstrate this is by referencing music. If you listen to a soft classical track and then listen to a heavy metal track, even though the volume levels might be the same, the heavy metal track is going to sound a lot louder. That's perceived loudness, and it's measured in loudness units full scale, or LUFS. Each loudness unit is equal to 1 decibel. What we're going to focus on in this video is the loudness unit's integrated field, which indicates a perceived loudness level for your entire video, and true peaks, the maximum level that a signal reaches or the loudest part of your video. The maximum loudness units for uploading to YouTube is negative 13 to negative 15 LUFS. That's the maximum loudness allowed, but to leave ourselves a little headroom, we'll aim for negative 16 LUFS. As far as true peaks go, anything over 0 decibels will be clipped, so we definitely want to stay away from that. For this example, we'll aim for negative 1.5 decibels, once again, to leave us a little headroom. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and take a look at how to loudness normalize your video. Normalizing loudness in your videos should be the last step. Before you do this, you should go through your project and properly mix the audio. What I mean by this is adjust the volume levels from different audio sources so they're relatively close to the same level. The way I do this in my videos is I start with a voice track. I usually turn this up until the average levels are bounced between minus 12 to minus 20 decibels. This ensures the peaks in my audio don't hit that 0 decibel level. After that, I adjust the music, sound effects, and any other audio levels relative to my voice track until it sounds right and all my audio levels are fairly consistent. And use to make your most used assets easier to find. Hey guys, what's up? There's a lot more to mixing, but today we'll be focusing on the next step. Before loudness normalizing your project or any other major editing phase, it's always a good idea to make a snapshot of your project, just so you have something to go back to in case you need to. Select your project in the media browser and press Shift Command D to take a snapshot of your project. Next, since we're trying to set the overall loudness for your entire project, you need to combine everything into one compound clip. Press Command A to select everything in your timeline, and Option G to make a compound clip. First thing you need to do is measure the overall loudness of your track. Press Command 5 to open the effects browser, scroll down to audio effects, and select the specialized category. Grab the multimeter effect and drag and drop it over your clip. This is strictly a measuring effect and will not affect your audio in any way. Head up to the inspector window, select the audio inspector, and click the icon beside multimeter to open up the controls. There's a couple things we'll focus on here. The loudness units integrated and true peaks, which you can display by choosing it from the levels drop-down menu. To get a proper measurement, you have to play through your entire track. In today's video, we'll take a look at how you can install custom titles, transitions, effects, and... My demo track measures an overall loudness level of minus 23.2 LUFS and just under negative 2 decibels at the loudest part. To hit our target volume of minus 16 LUFS, we need to bring up the levels by just over 7 decibels. The problem with this is if we just turn up the gain, then we'll be clipping the peaks. What we need to do is bring up the volume of the softer parts while leaving the louder parts pretty much the same. We have a bit of headroom with our peaks, but not much. To achieve this, there's a couple tools you can use, a compressor or a limiter. Personally, I find the limiter effect much easier to use, but both are very good options. Go back to the effects browser, select the levels category, and add the limiter effect to your clip. Whatever adjustment you make with this effect, in order to measure them with the multimeter, it has to come before the meter. In the audio inspector, select the limiter effect and drag it up above the multimeter effect. Click this limiter button to open up the controls. For this effect, I usually set the release time to about 250 milliseconds, output level to about negative 1.7 to 1.8 decibels to keep my true peaks under negative 1.5, and look ahead to about 5 milliseconds. I also switch to the legacy mode and make sure soft knee is turned on. Now, since we need to bring up our levels by about 7 decibels, let's start by turning the gain up by that amount. Play through your entire project to measure the loudness levels again. Since we're measuring loudness and not just the volume levels, just because we brought up the volume levels by 7 decibels doesn't mean our loudness will go up by the same amount. As you can see, our demo project loudness only went up by about 5 decibels. Go back to the limiter controls and adjust the settings again. The true peaks got up to about negative 1.6, so I'll bump this up by 0.1, bring up the gain to around 10, and play the track again. You might have to go back and forth a couple times to get the levels just right. Once again, we're aiming for negative 16 LUFS for your loudness, with true peaks not going over negative 1.5. Loudness normalizing your videos before uploading ensures your upload is loud enough for viewers to hear clearly, but not too loud. Also, if you do this to all your uploads, it brings consistency to your videos. So if the viewer chooses to watch more of your content, they don't have to worry about adjusting the volume levels on their device. Subtle things like this is the difference between good videos and great videos. Also, I strongly recommend you take the time to watch Curtis Judd's videos for a better understanding of this concept. But before you go watch them, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.